Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. As you know, we are studying lecture 12 about linear programming. Part 1 of this lecture number 12 has already been studied. Let us now study its part 2. So, in this part, we will also solve more problems of minimization and maximization of linear programming, keeping in view the special types of solutions which we have studied in part 1. So, I will try to repeat those solutions again so that you may comprehend easily and your concept is further strengthened. So, let us move ahead. What are our objectives? To visualize the optimization procedure explicitly and to understand the different terminologies associated with the solution of linear programming problems and to discuss an example with two decision variables. So these are the objectives. Example: minimize z is equal to 6x plus 5y subject to the structural constraints 2x minus 3y is less than equal to 5 and x plus 3y is less than equal to 11 and 4x plus y is less than equal to 15 and the non-negativity constraints are x and y greater than equal to 0. So, draw the structural constraints, draw the straight lines pertaining to the structural constraints. As you can see in the displayed slide, all those straight lines are drawn and this is the feasible region of solution. Now plot the objective function assuming any constant k. So here we are again assuming an arbitrary value of the objective function as was discussed in an example of part 1. Then by using the arbitrary value we found the value of the minimum value of the function z, and as far as I remember that was equal to 30. And then we solved the same problem by using the corner point method and the answer was the same. So in this case as well, we are assuming an arbitrary value k of the objective function. This is known as z line, which can be shifted perpendicularly by changing the value of k. So z line is shown in the diagram and it can be shifted perpendicularly by changing the value of k. So the optimal point as you can see, the objective function line is shifted by changing the value of k, and the optimal point is shown in the diagram. Now, find the value or the coordinates of this point xy by solving the equations of the constraints. X plus 3y is equal to 11 and 4x plus y is equal to 15. So multiply equation 1 by 4 and subtract it from the equation 2nd, we get the value of y is equal to 2.636. Now put this value in equation 1, x plus 3y is equal to 11, and we will find the value of x as 3.091. So to find the value of z, substitute these values in the objective function. Z is equal to 6x plus 5y, and the optimal solution is 31.726. So the problem is solved. Now, different cases of optimal solution. A linear programming problem may have a unique and finite solution. Example we have already discussed. An unbounded solution, ye bhi explain kiya ja chuka hai. Then multiple or infinite number of optimal solutions, then infeasible solution and a unique feasible point. So let me again repeat you the concepts of no feasible solution and unbounded solutions. The system of constraints in a linear programming problem may have no points which satisfy all constraints. In such cases, there are no points in the solution set, and the linear programming problem is said to have no feasible solution. Then unbounded solution, वो डायग्राम मैं आपको दोबारा दिखाऊंगा. द डायग्राम 10.14 इलस्ट्रेट्स दैट द व्हाट इज टर्म्ड एज अनबाउंडेड सॉल्यूशन स्पेस. द टू कंस्ट्रेंट्स अपीयर टू बी ग्रेटर देन टाइप विद द रिजल्टिंग सॉल्यूशन स्पेस एक्सटेंडिंग आउटवर्ड एन इन्फिनिट डिस्टेंस हैविंग नो बाउंड. सो गिवन एन अनबाउंडेड सॉल्यूशन स्पेस द ऑप्टिमल वैल्यू ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन मे बी बाउंडेड और अनबाउंडेड. If the direction of the improvement in the objective function is toward the origin, typically a minimization objective, there would be a bound on the value of z, and it would be realized at corner points A, B, or C. However, if the direction of the improvement is outward, away from the origin, typically maximization, the objective function can be shifted out an infinite distance. Thus, there is no bound on the value of the objective function, and the problem is said to have an unbounded solution. So, diagram mein dekhen, the figure 10.13, no feasible solution. Aur ye pehle bhi aapko dono figure dikhai ja chuki hain part 1 mein. So, figure 10.14 represents the unbounded solution space. Now, unbounded solution, graphical representation, situation, if the feasible region is not bounded, solution, it is possible that the value of the objective function goes on in increasing without leaving the feasible region, that is unbounded solution. As you can see, is shown in the diagram. Multiple solutions, graphical representation, situation. Z line is parallel to any side of the feasible region, and solution, देखें, all the points lying on that side constitute optimal solution. The objective function is parallel. Both are, Z line is parallel to any one side of the feasible region, and all the points lying on that side constitute the optimal solution. Infeasible solution, इसकी graphical representation देखें. Solution set, situation, set of constraints does not form a feasible region at all due to inconsistency in the constraints. Or solution, optimal solution is not feasible. Unique feasible point, graphical representation, situation. Feasible region consists of a single point. Number of constraints should be at least equal to the number of decision variables. Solution. There is no need for optimization as there is only one feasible point where both the straight lines intersect. I hope that the concept about the different types of solutions is now quite clear. Now let us again revise it. A linear programming problem. The maximization or minimization of some quantity is the objective in all linear programming problems. So objective kya hota hai? Maximization or minimization of the linear programming problem, then all linear programming problems have constraints that limit the degree to which the objective function can be pursued. And a feasible solution satisfies all the problem constraints. An optimal solution is a feasible solution that results in the largest possible objective function value when maximizing or smallest when minimizing. A graphical solution method can be used to solve a linear program with two variables. If both the objective function and the constraints are linear, the problem is referred to as a linear programming problem. And linear functions are functions in which each variable appears in a separate term raised to the first power and is multiplied by a constant which could be zero. And linear constraints are linear functions that are restricted to be less than or equal to or greater than or equal to a constant. Now problem formulation. Let us now study how to formulate a linear programming problem. Problem formulation or modeling is the process of translating a verbal statement of a problem into a mathematical statement. So guidelines for model formulation kya hai? Understand the problem thoroughly. Describe the objective. Describe each constraint. Define the decision variables. Write the objective in terms of the decision variables and write the constraints in terms of the decision variables. So, ye sare step jab hum karenge, to the problem will be formulated. Example dekhen, a maximization problem. 5x1 maximize 5x1 plus 7x2 subject to the constraints x1 is less than or equal to 6, 2x1 plus 3x2 is less than or equal to 19, and x1 plus x2 is less than or equal to 8, and x1 and x2 are both greater than 0. So, draw the constraints. After finding the vertices of the points x1 and x2, so this is the constraint graphed x1 is less than or equal to 6. Then this is the constraint 2x1 plus 3x2 is less than or equal to 19. So vertices of both points are given. Jinko join karne ke baad ye straight line hamare paas aayi hai. This is the third one, x1 plus x2 is less than or equal to 8, or vertices are 0, 8 and 8, 0. Now, tino line akatti show ki gayi hai, tino constraints. And this is the feasible region where our solution lies. अब ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन जो है इसको अज्यूम करें इसकी वैल्यू 35. तो इसकी जो स्ट्रेट लाइन है दैट इज शोन विद द हेल्प ऑफ एरोस एंड इट हैज द वर्टिसेस 0, 5 and 7, 0. So, the optimal solution lies at the corner point x1 is equal to 5, x2 is equal to 3. Aur agar aap recall karein, to ye problem hum part 1 mein solve kar chuke hain. Aur slide number 28 of part 1, jo hai usme iske sare corner points ke coordinates diye hue hain. और ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन भी दिया हुआ है. आई विल ओनली रिपीट द कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ द कॉर्नर पॉइंट्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इज द ओरिजिन 0, 0, वेयर द फंक्शन z हैज 0 वैल्यू. ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन की वैल्यू 0 है. देन इज द पॉइंट 6, 0, कॉर्नर पॉइंट हैविंग द वर्टिसेस 6, 0 और कोऑर्डिनेट 6, 0, उस पे z की वैल्यू है 30. देन 6, 2, वहां पे इन पॉइंट्स पे ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन की वैल्यू 44. देन वी हैव द कोऑर्डिनेट 5, 3 और इस पॉइंट पे दिस इज द पॉइंट वेयर द ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन लाइज और ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन की वैल्यू मैक्सिमाइज हो जाती है इज इक्वल टू 46. देन वी हैव अनदर पॉइंट 0, कॉर्नर पॉइंट 0 एंड 19 ओवर 3 विद वर्टिसेस 0 एंड 19 ओवर 3 और फंक्शन की जो ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन की वैल्यू यहां पे है 44.33. सो नाउ हियर दिस इज सॉल्वड विद द हेल्प ऑफ अज्यूमिंग an arbitrary value or giving an arbitrary value to the objective function aur wo value jo humne isko di wo 35 di. So the answer is the same. Extreme points and the optimal solution. The corners and vertices of the feasible region are referred to as the extreme points. An optimal solution to and linear programming problem, a linear programming problem can be found at an extreme point of the feasible region. When looking for the optimal solution, we do not have to evaluate all feasible solution points. We have to consider only the extreme point of the feasible region. Is method se jo abhi humne kiya hai, jab hum usko koi arbitrary value dete hain to fir hame sare corner points pe objective function ki value nahi nikalni padti. So summary of the graphical solution procedure for maximization problems. ये वही है जो मैं दो तीन दफा से ज्यादा दोहरा चुका हूं, सो आई विल नाउ इम्प्लीमेंट इट ऑन द न्यूमेरिकल और ऑन द प्रैक्टिकल प्रॉब्लम. नाउ द स्पेशल केसेस, ऑल्टरनेट ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन. इन द ग्राफिकल मेथड, इफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन लाइन इज पैरेलल टू ए बाउंड्री कंस्ट्रेंट इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ऑप्टिमाइजेशन, there are alternate optimal solutions with all points on this line segment being optimal. In feasibility, a linear program which is over constrained so that no point satisfies all the constraints is said to be infeasible. And unboundedness, I have already explained it more than twice. So we will also see it in an example. Already भी हम इसकी examples कर चुके हैं इन तीनों cases की इसकी, और इनको मैं explain कर चुका हूँ इन solutions को, special solutions को part 1 में भी और part 2 में भी. तो अब इनको आपकी further comprehension के लिए I have defined these once again. तो इनफिजिबल प्रॉब्लम देखें, मैक्सिमाइज 2x1 प्लस 6x2 सब्जेक्ट टू द कंस्ट्रेंट्स 4x1 प्लस 3x2 इज लेस देन इक्वल टू 12 एंड 2x1 प्लस x2 ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 8 एंड द नॉन नेगेटिविटी कंस्ट्रेंट्स आर x1 एंड x2 ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 0. तो दोनों देखें, देयर आर नो पॉइंट्स दैट सेटिस्फाई बोथ कंस्ट्रेंट्स. And this problem has no feasible region and no optimal solution. So, यहीं पे ये problem जो है ये solve हो गई है. Unbounded की problem देखें, maximize 3x1 plus 4x2 subject to the constraints x1 plus x2 greater than equal to 5 and 3x1 plus x2 greater than equal to 8. और नॉन नेगेटिविटी कंस्ट्रेंट्स आर x1 एंड x2 ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 0. सो द फिजिबल रीजन इज अनबाउंडेड. जैसा कि आप देख सकते हैं डायग्राम में, द फिजिबल रीजन इज अनबाउंडेड एंड द ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन लाइन कैन बी मूव्ड पैरेलल टू इटसेल्फ विदाउट बाउंड सो दैट g कैन बी इंक्रीज्ड इन्फिनिटली. So now let us discuss another example of maximization completely. So this problem is a product mix problem. Beaver Creek Pottery Company है. How many bowls and mugs should be produced to maximize profits given labor and materials constraints? So product क्या है? Product resource requirements and unit profile is given in the table. Product number 1 is bowl. इसके लिए पर यूनिट लेबर इज 1 आवर और क्ले इज पर यूनिट इज 4 pounds एंड प्रॉफिट पर यूनिट इज $40. सिमिलरली फॉर द मग, द रिस्पेक्टिव वैल्यूज for labor, clay and profit are 2, 3 and 50 respectively. ध्यान से समझिएगा, रिसोर्सेज आर 40 आवर्स ऑफ लेबर पर डे और अवेलेबिलिटी इज 120 पाउंड ऑफ क्ले. सो डिसीजन वेरिएबल्स, लेट एक्स वन बी इक्वल टू द नंबर ऑफ बाउल्स टू बी प्रोड्यूस्ड पर डे एंड एक्स टू इज इक्वल टू द नंबर ऑफ मग्स टू बी प्रोड्यूस्ड पर डे. Now the our objective function is maximize z is equal to $40 x1 plus $50 x2. This is our objective function where z is the profit per day or resource constraints. जिनको हम स्ट्रक्चरल कंस्ट्रेंट्स भी कह सकते हैं वो हैं 1x1 प्लस 2x2 इज लेस देन इक्वल टू 40 आवर्स पर डे पर लेस देन इक्वल टू 40 आवर्स ऑफ लेबर एंड 4x1 प्लस 3x2 इज लेस देन इक्वल टू 120 पाउंड्स ऑफ क्ले. और नॉन नेगेटिविटी कंस्ट्रेंट्स हैं x1 इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 0 एंड x2 इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 0. ये कंस्ट्रेंट्स यहां से बनी हैं ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन प्रॉफिट से और कंस्ट्रेंट्स ये लेबर और क्ले की जो रिक्वायरमेंट है फॉर बाउल्स एंड मग्स. नाउ लेट अस कंप्लीट अवर लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग मॉडल. मैक्सिमाइज जी इज इक्वल टू 40x1 plus 50x2 subject to the structural constraints. So 1x1 we can call it x1 plus 2x2 is less than equal to 40 and 4x1 plus 3x2 is less than equal to 20 or non-negativity constraints hai, x1 x2 greater than equal to 0. So a feasible solution does not violate any of the constraints. गौर से समझिएगा, जो feasible solution है वो ऐसा होता है जो किसी भी constraint को violate नहीं करता. So let us take an example of manufacturing 5 bowls and 10 mugs. So x1 is equal to 5 bowls and x2 is equal to 10 mugs. So when we put these values of x1 and x2 in the objective function, so z is equal to $700. Let us now put these assumed values of x1 and x2 in the constraints. So labor constraint is equal to 25, which is less than 40 hours within constraint. So lay constraint check is when we put the values 5 and 10 in constraint number 2, we get 50 is less than 120 pounds, which is correct. So within constraint. Now an infeasible solution violates at least one of the constraints. Now let us explain it again with the help of example. With the help of an example, let x1 be equal to 10 bowls and x2 be equal to 20 mugs. So when we put these values in the objective function, we get z is equal to $1,400. Now labor constraint mein ye value put karein, so we get 50 is greater than 40. So constraint is violated because 50 cannot be greater than 40. So this is an example of an infeasible solution because the constraint number 1 is violated. The set of all points that satisfy all the constraints of the model is called a feasible region. ये अब आपको अच्छी तरह इल्म हो चुका है. सो यहां पे इसको again with the help of example show kiya gaya hai, the set of all points that satisfy all the constraints of the model is called a feasible region. Now, graphical solution is limited to linear programming models containing only two decision variables. यानी लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग के जो मॉडल्स हैं वो दो वेरिएबल्स से ग्राफिकल सॉल्यूशन के जरिए हल हो सकते हैं. कैन बी यूज्ड विद थ्री वेरिएबल्स बट ओनली विद ग्रेट डिफिकल्टी. सो हम ऐसी कोई एग्जांपल हम इसमें डिस्कस नहीं करेंगे. ग्राफिकल मेथड प्रोवाइड विजुअलाइजेशन ऑफ हाउ अ सॉल्यूशन फॉर लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम इज ऑब्टेन्ड. Primary advantage of two variable linear programming models such as Beaver Creek problem is their solution can be graphically illustrated using two dimensional graph. Allows one to provide an intuitive explanation of how more complex solution procedures work for larger लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग मॉडल्स. अब देखें, दिस इज द कार्टेशियन प्लेन एंड द मॉडल इज गिवन. वी हैव टू मैक्सिमाइज z इक्वल टू द सेम फंक्शन $40x1 + $50x2 सब्जेक्ट टू द कंस्ट्रेंट्स x1 + 2x2 is less than equal to 40 and 4x1 + 3x2 is less than equal to 120. These are the structural constraints or non-negativity constraints bhi wahi hai, x1 and x2 or non-negative constraints the same, greater than equal to x1 x2 greater than equal to 0. Now plot the straight line x1 + 2x2 is less than equal to 40 by assuming x1 + x2 is equal to 40. जिस तरह हम पहले करते आए हैं तो coordinates हमारे पास आ जाएंगे 40, 0. When we will put x2 is equal to 0, so x1 will be equal to 40. And when we will put x1 is equal to 0, x2 will be equal to 20. So plot the points 40, 0 and 0, 20 on the horizontal and the vertical line and join the two and we get the straight line x1 + 2x2 is equal to 40. Now plot or graph the straight line 4x1 + 3x2 is less than equal to 120 by assuming or putting it 4x1 + 3x2 is equal to 120. So first of all, to plot or graph this straight line in the Cartesian plane, put x1 is equal to 0, we get x2 is equal to 40. So 0 and 40 is the one point. Now put x2 is equal to 0 and we get x1 is equal to 30. So the dusra point hai 30, 0. Dono ko plot karein aur join karein. So you can see that 4x1 + 3x2 is equal to 120 is the straight line which you can see in the slide which I have displayed. Now corner point property, it is a very important property of linear programming problems. This property states optimal solution to linear programming problems This property states optimal solution to linear programming problem will always occur at a corner point. So let us see the corner points in this case. Now we have three corner points. A ke vertices hain 0 or 20. So x1 is equal to 0 both and x2 is equal to 20 marks. Put this in this objective function. So we get z is equal to $1000. Ab jo C point hai, uske vertices hain 30 and 0. That is x1 is equal to 30 both and x2 is equal to 0 marks. When we put these values in the objective function, z is equal to 40 x1 plus 50 x2, we get z is equal to $1200. Now, to find the value of the objective function at the corner point B, first of all, find the coordinates of the point B. So, multiply the objective function 1, multiply the constraint 1 with 4. We get 4x1 plus 8x2 is equal to 160. Now subtract this equation from the equation 4x1 plus 3x2 is less than or equal to 120, and we will get the value x2 is equal to 8. Put this value in the equation x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 40, and we will get x1 is equal to 24. So simultaneously, jab hum in dono equation ko solve karenge, to humare paas x1 is equal to 24 moles aur x2 is equal to 8 mugs. Now when we put these values in the objective function, z is equal to $40 x1 plus $50 x2, so we get z is equal to $1360. This is the optimal point. Here the objective function is maximized, and the value of the maximized function, or the objective function, or the maximum value of the objective function is z is equal to $1360. So with this we come to the end of the part 2 of lecture 12 as well. I hope that now you have understood it very clearly. Maine bahut zyada examples solve karke कोशिश की है आपको लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग के प्रॉब्लम्स सॉल्व करके ये टॉपिक समझाने की, और मुझे पूरी उम्मीद है कि अब आप इसको अच्छी तरह समझ चुके हैं. द ओनली जॉब यू हैव नाउ टू परफॉर्म इज to make practice, because practice will further strengthen your concepts and you will command the subject, command the topic. तो इस तरीके से आप किसी तरह की भी आपको linear programming की अगर कोई problem solve करनी होगी, whether it pertains to maximization or minimization, तो आप आसानी से उसको सॉल्व कर सकेंगे. ओके देन, अस्सलामु अलैकुम एंड अल्लाह हाफिज़.